and welcome to this week's episode of Kids Church Online. I'm so excited that you've come to join us for this great episode. We've got a great episode. We're continuing our series looking at Old Testament characters, and this week we're looking at someone very special. Her name is Ruth. What?
This is gonna be impossible.
Sliding dice.
Oh no!
Battleship on your head.
Oh. Time to pick my next button.
100 bottles in a row, and the last one not your neck.
My second one.
Roll a coin into a
pool. Easy!
10
cap
in a row.
10!
Hannah needs to land a mini bottle.
I caught Hannah right before she had to go to bed.
Yes, good job, Hannah.
Wait, what? Where are you going?
Score 150 points on the Papa Shot.
Okay, you gotta flip the water bottle.
Yay!
Skip any trick shot you want. Out the window,
bounce
shot.
Looks like that's it for the day.
There once was a woman named Ruth who lived in a land called Moab. Ruth married into the family of a woman named Naomi. But all of the men in Naomi's family died, and Ruth was left without a husband. One day, Naomi decided to go back to her homeland of Israel, and Ruth decided to go with her. On their journey, Naomi said to Ruth, "Go back to your mother's home. May the Lord bless you." But Ruth was determined to go on with Naomi, and Ruth said, "Don't ask me to leave you. Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you live, I will live. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God." Through love and kindness, Ruth would not give up on Naomi. God had a plan for Ruth and guided her along the way. The Lord provided Ruth with a job working in a field, and Ruth never gave up. Ruth followed her heart, and in doing so, God rewarded her faithfulness. She married a godly man, and Ruth's son would carry out God's plan to bring Jesus to this earth.
Ruth was the daughter-in-law of Naomi. Both of their husbands died, and Naomi said Ruth did not have to stay with her anymore. But Ruth told Naomi, "Don't ask me to leave. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your friends will be my friends, and your God will be my God." So Ruth and Naomi went to Bethlehem together. It was a good thing Ruth went with Naomi, because Bethlehem was very far away, and Naomi could not have traveled all that way by herself. Ruth never complained, but was a good friend to Naomi. She just wanted to help her. When they got there, Ruth decided she should do some kind of work. It was harvest time, so she worked in the fields. A man named Boaz owned the field. Boaz came by to greet the workers and notice Ruth. He saw her kindness to Naomi and said to her, "Don't go work in any other field, but stay here with the others. I will make sure you are safe and have food and water. I know what you have done for Naomi." Boaz even gave Ruth extra food. She took it home and shared it with Naomi.
God's story, Ruth. So part of God's story is about a woman named Ruth, and it begins like this. Ruth lived in a place called Moab and was married to a guy who was part of God's special family, the Israelites. A few years later, though, Ruth's husband died. Instead of returning to her family, which would have been expected, she stayed with Naomi, her husband's mom. Naomi tried to get Ruth to go back to her family in Moab, but Ruth wouldn't leave Naomi, no matter what. In fact, she wanted to go back to Israel with her. Ruth said, "Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God." So they both returned to Naomi's home in Bethlehem. Back then, though, it was hard for women to find work. Usually, they had to be taken care of by their husband or a dad. It's really hard to imagine that now, but Naomi and Ruth might not have even known how they'd survive. At first, to get food, Ruth went to the fields of a man named Boaz and followed his harvesters around. If they dropped anything, even just a piece of grain, she picked it up. This was called gleaning. Ruth worked from morning to night and barely even took a break. Boaz noticed. He told his workers to leave behind some extra grain for her to gather. When Naomi heard about this, she was overjoyed because Boaz was Naomi's relative and what's called a family redeemer. That meant that it was his responsibility to take care of his family. If anybody was going to rescue Ruth and Naomi, it was Boaz. Kids, we have a redeemer too. It's Jesus. He's the one who saves us. Anyway, this gave Naomi an idea. She told Ruth to put on her best clothes and perfume and then go to the place where Boaz was sleeping. Naomi said that once Boaz had gone to sleep, Ruth should lay down by his feet. Now, this may sound like a weird plan, but it was actually really brave. Ruth trusted Naomi and obeyed. When Boaz woke up, he was surprised. After all, someone was lying at his feet. That's not exactly a normal night. When Boaz asked who Ruth was, she said, "I am your servant. You are my family redeemer." Now Boaz understood. Ruth wanted Boaz to marry her so that she and Naomi would both be taken care of. Boaz agreed. This was a huge deal. Ruth wasn't an Israelite, but she wanted to follow God anyway. By marrying Boaz, she got to officially be part of God's family. In fact, Ruth's great-grandson was King David, and many, many years later, Jesus, the rescuer, was born into the same family line. Now, because of Jesus, we get to be a part of God's family too. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Ruth was from Moab. Her husband died. Ruth was left with his mom, Naomi. Naomi told her to go home. Ruth said no. She went to Israel with Naomi. They needed someone to take care of them. Ruth gleaned in a field. Boaz noticed. He left extra grain for Ruth. Naomi made a plan. Ruth obeyed it. She wanted to marry Boaz. He agreed. Ruth became part of God's special family. And we can too.
Now, in the story of Ruth, there are three really important characters. Character number one is Ruth. You guessed it. Character number two is a girl called Naomi. She befriends Ruth. In fact, they're like a little team working together to try and do good and be good. And then the character number four is Boaz, okay? What a crazy name. I'm going to name my child Boaz. Boaz is an incredible character. He chooses to show love and kindness to Ruth, even though it would have been, in the time, a little bit mental, a little bit crazy, a little bit unheard of. And yet Boaz goes out of his way, you could say, to show kindness and love to Ruth. He displays a picture of what God's love is towards you and me. God always shows us love. He always shows us kindness. In fact, the Bible says that he's slow to anger and abounding in love. That's what the kindness of God is like. He has adopted you and me into his family. We're chosen sons and daughters, not just of that guy called Boaz in the Old Testament, but we're chosen sons and daughters of God, the living God, because of what Jesus has done. How special is that? Now, in the story, it's really important to know that Ruth was an outsider, and Boaz chose to show kindness and love to Ruth. He ended up marrying Ruth. They had a son called Obed, okay, off to bed. No, his name was Obed, and he was David, King David's granddad. So he's a really special character in the Bible as well. Now, what's really important to know is that we too, just like Boaz showed Ruth love and kindness, as an outsider, we too are called to show love and kindness to the outsiders, to people that maybe are pushed out, feeling a little bit lonely and isolated. We're called to love them and to show kindness towards them, just as God has showed kindness towards you and me. We've been adopted into God's family, and so what that means is that we get to show love and kindness to those around us, particularly to the ones that are hurting and the ones that are maybe pushed out by everyone else. We're called to go and love those ones, to go and be kind towards those ones. How special is that? Now, another really special, important thing to know in the story of Ruth is that Boaz, before he can marry Ruth, he actually has to pay a price. Back in the time, they had to pay money in order to make sure that they could be move things forward in marriage. And Boaz, he has to go and pay a high price for Ruth. Now, that was unheard of at the time, but Boaz still paid a great price. Because he loved her. He wanted to be married to her, in a relationship with her. Now, you might be thinking, well, that's a bit like a beautiful love story. Well, guess what? God has paid the price for you and for me. He's not just paid the price in terms of money and coin, but he's paid the price through Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for your sin and for my sin, for all of our shame, all of our wrongdoing. He went and chose to pay the ultimate sacrifice out of love for you and for me. How incredible is that?
Half. Two and three quarters.
Who's more?
Oh! Hey, John, you just hit me!
Let's do it!
Wait, hold on!
Ready, go!
of who you are, my heart will give you praise. For everything you've done, my heart will celebrate.
We are going to pray together right now, and we're going to thank God that He's shown us love and kindness, that He's paid for us the ultimate price. Come on, let's thank Him right now. Dear God, we thank You so much that You've chosen to love us, that You've chosen to show kindness towards us, and that You have paid the ultimate price. And because of that, we're adopted into Your family. We thank You for Jesus. We thank You for all of these amazing things, that all that we've been learning in Kids Church today. Amen. Amazing! I hope that you've had as much fun as we have in Kids Church today. We look forward to seeing you next time. Have an awesome week. See you later. Bye!